uprated Saturn I, Saturn 1B Quarterly Film Reports number 30 covers progress during the months of October, November, and December 1966. At the Kennedy Space Center, pre-launch activities for the Apollo-Saturn 204 mission continued throughout the quarter. Launch of the first manned uprated Saturn I spacecraft was rescheduled for next quarter because of spacecraft problems. In addition, the uprated Saturn I launch schedule has been revised because of further spacecraft delay. Saturn 206, which will carry a lunar module, is now the next vehicle scheduled for launch. Apollo Saturn 205 and 208 will be launched next summer for the first Apollo uprated Saturn I dual launch mission. Checkout of Saturn 204 was satisfactory, except for one booster engine which was replaced due to a turbo pump problem. The first manned flight is scheduled to last up to 14 days. The prime missions will be to evaluate the performance of the spacecraft and its crew during Earth orbit, and to evaluate the performance of the launch vehicle. Following modification of the 70-inch LOX tanks, the booster for Saturn 206 was shipped from Michoud December 13th and arrived at KSC 5 days later. In parallel with first stage shipment, the second stage was shipped from the West Coast by Super Guppy December 13th and arrived at KSC the next day. Checkout of the instrument unit for Saturn 206 was completed in November at IBM. The unit was shipped December 16th and arrived at KSC the next day. At Marshall, work efforts continue with manufacturing of nose cones for lunar module space vehicles. The nose cone for Apollo Saturn 206 vehicle is to be shipped to KSC next quarter. The mission for Apollo Saturn 206 will be to place a lunar module into Earth orbit, primarily to verify the module's propulsion subsystem. Verification will include firing its engine remotely and subjecting it to various maneuvers. Saturn 205 stages will be shipped to the Cape next quarter. The booster and the second stage are presently stored at the manufacturer's facilities. The instrument unit is undergoing necessary modifications for the new mission. At Michoud, post-static work is in progress on the Saturn 207 booster. During checkout, a decision was made to replace one engine in which pieces of Teflon were found. The problem was investigated and determined to be an isolated case. Checkout of the booster is continuing well ahead of schedule. The booster for Saturn 208 was received at MSFC October 25th. Upon delivery, it was placed in the static test stand. A short duration firing was conducted on November 16th. One engine displayed a lower than normal thrust, requiring replacement. A long duration firing was completed November 29th. The stage is back at Michoud undergoing post-static modifications and rework. There, it was discovered that four engines were defective because wrong material, 316 stainless steel instead of Haynes stellite alloy, was used for manufacturing. After rework, the engines will be returned from Neosho to Michoud for reinstallation in late January. Defective blades also were found in engines on AS-204, 207, 208, 209, and 210. These are being replaced or reworked. Following completion of assembly of the booster for Saturn 209 late last quarter, the stage was at Michoud for pre-static checkout. Shipment to Marshall for planned static firing is on schedule. Assembly and engine installation on the booster for Saturn 210 continued through this report period. Pre-static checkout of the stage is scheduled for next quarter. Tail section assembly of Saturn 211 booster was completed in October. Tank clustering began November 14th with installation of the final LOX tank, completed December 1st. Final assembly is ahead of schedule. Fabrication work on the booster for Saturn 212 is in process and ahead of schedule. Assembly is planned to start next quarter. MSFC and Chrysler have negotiated a contract for the procurement of long lead time items for four more stages to maintain production capability on a temporary basis. At the Michoud Assembly Facility, the first stage 70-inch LOX tank qualification testing was completed this quarter. The 70-inch LOX tank had met the unmanned 125% safety factor test. The tank had also been qualified to 140% of design flight loads. However, a failure occurred which resulted in pre-flight ground wind restrictions. In order to relieve the wind restrictions, the tank was modified in the upper skirt to redistribute structural loads. In mid-December, the modified tank was tested to 140% of the most critical loads, and the pre-launch wind restrictions were eliminated. Testing of the LOX tanks is complete. At Douglas's SACTO facility, the second stage for Saturn 207 underwent a 447-second acceptance firing October 19th. Post-static checkout was completed November 23rd. The stage is presently undergoing minor modifications. Upon completion, the stage will be stored until it is shipped to the Cape. Factory checkout of the second stage for Saturn 208 was completed October 25th. It was shipped to SACTO by Super Guppy December 14th and was offloaded the next day. Pre-static checkout is underway. Contractor efforts continued this quarter with fabrication and assembly of the second stages for the 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th uprated Saturn I vehicles. During hydrostatic testing of Saturn 210 second stage, water seeped into the common bulkhead due to an improperly sealed fitting. To prevent program schedule delay, the common bulkhead and propellant tanks for the 11th stage were moved up in the production schedule to replace the defective items. Following successful drying procedures, the 10th stage hardware was accepted as flight-worthy and placed back in the manufacturing schedule for the 11th stage. Completion of the 12th second stage will close the present contract. MSFC and Douglas have agreed to a contract for the procurement of long lead time items for four more stages to temporarily maintain production capability. At IBM Huntsville, work continued on the instrument unit for Saturn 207. Checkout of the IU was begun December 16th and is scheduled for completion next quarter. Structural fabrication of the instrument unit for Saturn 208 was completed November 22nd. Component installation is underway with completion planned for next quarter. Structural segments for Saturn 209 IU arrived at IBM November 29th. Fabrication began December 8th with completion planned next quarter. At Marshall's Systems Development Facility, new and improved techniques in ground support equipment and testing are being used to accomplish automation to check out and launch the uprated Saturn I vehicle. This is the facility utilized to debug and validate checkout program tapes. It contains a computer complex, a telemetry station, digital data checkout station, networks, and associated vehicle components, actual or simulated. Simulated flight tests are fed to RDA 110A computers on programmed tape. As many as 115 identified tests and subroutines will be programmed for future testing of uprated Saturn I vehicles. Validation of the program tapes is accomplished in three phases. First, electrical support equipment and integration equipment, systems which are a part of or related to the booster. Second, equipment related to the second stage. And third, the instrument unit. The systems development facility allows for a comprehensive checkout for overall systems compatibility. It also serves as a supporting unit for CAPE operations during checkout and launch. In summary, October, November, and December were months of continued progress within the uprated Saturn program. Final preparations for the manned flight of Apollo Saturn 204. Arrival of Saturn 206 stages at Cape Kennedy. Successful acceptance testing of the second stage for Saturn 207. Successful acceptance testing of the booster for Saturn 208. And testing of software related to the uprated Saturn vehicles at Marshall's Systems Development Facility, linking MSFC and the Cape in a joint checkout of uprated Saturn I prior to flight.